This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're going to continue solving nonlinear polynomial inequalities. And make sure you first watch my introduction to solving nonlinear polynomial inequalities. And on this video, we're going to solve this one. X cubed is greater than 9x. These are the steps we took on the last video. I did not write them out, but let's look at it. First, we wrote the inequality with 0 on one side. Then we factored the other side. We set each factor to 0, and we solved each equation to find critical points, which I'll call CP. And then we're going to mark those critical points on a number line. If the inequality has less than or equal or greater than or equal, we're going to put a dot on those number on the number line because that's actually a solution. Those are actual solutions. But if it's just strictly less than or greater than, we're going to put a circle to show that those are not solutions. And then we're going to test the intervals with other numbers to find the rest of the solutions. All right, so we're going to do this problem. X cubed is greater than 9x. All right, step one was to set the inequality to where we would have a 0 on one side. So let's subtract 9x from both sides. We have x cubed minus 9x is greater than 0. Next step, this is similar to solving equations, is we factor. So let's see, on the left-hand side I have x cubed minus 9x. The first step in factoring is always to see if there's a common factor, and if so, you take out the greatest common factor. So x cubed minus 9x, we've got x as a common factor. That gives us x squared minus 9. And then we can factor x squared minus 9 to x plus 3 times x minus 3. So what we have here are three factors, x, x plus 3, and x minus 3. We set each factor to 0, so x equals 0. Or x plus 3 equals 0, or x minus 3 equals 0, and solve each of them. X equals 0 is solved, and we solve these other two. These give us our critical points. So our critical points, I'm going to write here, are 0, negative 3, and 3. Now notice this is strictly greater than. That means if I plugged in this critical point into the original equation or in the factor, notice if I put in 0 in for x up at the top. So what would happen if I plugged in 0? 0 cubed is greater than 9 times 0 would say is 0 is greater than 0. That would be false. So what this is telling, the critical points are not solutions. Same thing would happen if you put in 3 or negative 3. So since they're not solutions, we're going to put circles on the number line. Okay, so we need to move down a little bit to get all this in. Let's take this original equation again, and then we're going to write our number line. I'm going to go on to a new page to show that. All right, so here's our original problem. X cubed is greater than 9x. We factored it, and we found these critical points, 0, negative 3, and 3. So we're going to mark those on a number line. So we have a number line. And we have to mark it. So let's say this is where 0 is. Let's say that's where negative 3 is. And here's where 3 is. Those are our critical points. So the first question is, are those critical points solutions? In other words, if you plugged in negative 3, would this be a true inequality when I plugged in 0 or 3? Well, that's really based on this symbol here. Since it's strictly greater than, it's not going to be. If you want to see why not, plug in x equals 0. If you want to know if x equals 0 is a solution, you would say, is 0 cubed greater than 9 times 0? In other words, that would ask you, is 0 greater than 0? That's false, right? So 0 is not a solution to this inequality. The same thing will happen for negative 3 or 3. So just make a note, these are not solutions. These are just the critical points. So I need to use circles to show they are not part of the solution. Okay. Now what do I want my solution to be? I want it to be positive because I want the product to be greater than 0. So the solutions, the product of these will be positive. So I'm looking for positive numbers that make this product positive. Okay, so keep that in mind. That's what we're looking for. That greater than 0 means I'm looking for something positive. All right, so now we're going to test the intervals. I have 4 intervals. To the left of negative 3, in between negative 3 and 0, in between 0 and 3, and bigger than 3. And we're going to decide if we pick a number over in each interval, if I plug it in to this equation you see right here, I'm sorry, this inequality you see right here, do you get a positive number when you plug in numbers in that interval for x? Now it doesn't matter what you plug in, and you could actually plug it an actual number and do all the computation. I always just decide whether it's going to be positive or negative when I plug in a particular number. So for instance, let's say I'm going to try, all right, a number to the left of negative 3, like, you know, how about negative 10? It really doesn't matter. The point is, when I plug it in to this boxed answer here, all right, so if x is negative 10, the first factor x will just be a negative number. Okay. When I plug in negative 10 in the next parentheses, negative 10 plus 3, that's a negative number as well. And when I plug it into negative 10 minus 3, well, that would be negative as well. And the question is, what's a negative times a negative times a negative? Is that positive or negative? It's negative. So I know it's going to be negative in this region. And I'm looking to see where it's positive. So you could either write a negative sign there, or you could write the word negative. That's up to you. This is going to tell me over here, these are not going to be solutions to this original inequality. Now pick a number in between negative 3 and 0. So let's try, how about x equals negative 1? All right, so I'm putting in negative 1 for x. The first factor x is simply negative, because, you know, negative 1 is obviously just a negative number. Negative 1 plus 3, that's a positive number. And negative 1 minus 3, that's a negative number. So a negative times a positive times a negative, what does that give you? That gives me a positive number. So, or you could write positive, whatever is easier for you. We know that right in between here, these are definitely a solution. You could do that now, or later you can fill that in on your graph. I'm going to go ahead and do it now real quick. Let's do a marker in here. I know that if one test point in there works, any other number between negative 3 and 0 is also going to work. Okay, let's go back to finding the rest, see about the interval between 0 and 3. So let's try x equals 2. Okay, so I'm going to put in 2 for x up into what is the original inequality up there. So if I put in 2, I get positive. Right, 2 is just a positive number when I plug it in for x. When I put 2 plus 3, that's also positive. And when I put in 2 minus 3, it's negative. All right, so it's a positive times a positive times a negative. That's going to be negative. So that's not going to be a solution, right, because I'm looking for values that are going to make this inequality positive, make it true, positive. Anyway, we're going to pick numbers to the right of 3, pick any number you want. Again, how about you try 100? Doesn't matter what you're plugging in for x, right? Okay, so we're going to put 100 in for x. Well, then x itself is positive. X plus 3, 100 plus 3, that's also positive. X minus 3, 100 minus 3 is also positive. So positive times a positive is positive. Great, and that's what we're looking for, right? So that also is a solution, all the numbers, and of course the interval goes all the way to infinity. So what you see here is the solution to this problem. Now, you might say, why didn't you check it into the original inequality? You can. It's just that you have to do more arithmetic here. So let's say you plugged in 2 into this original inequality up here. You'd have 2 cubed, which is 8, is greater than 9 times 2. That would be false. So notice that's why in this interval of 2, you would not select the interval between 0 and 3. So it's up to you. If it's preferable to plug it into the original inequality as opposed to plugging it into the each factor after I've factored, that's okay as well. Same thing if you want to plug a number bigger than 100, you could say, bigger than 3, excuse me. So let's say you tested 10. If you want, you could put 10 cubed. Is that greater than 9 times 10? Is 1,000 greater than 90? Yes, and that's why the solution's here. So it's really up to you. This is just how I'm used to testing my intervals. So here's the graphical solution, and now you can also write that in interval notation. So let's finish. So the solution, well, there's 2 different places. It's between negative 3 and 0, and it does not include negative 3 or 0. So you use parentheses. So the solution is between negative 3 and 0, and also, which means we use the union symbol, from 3 to infinity. So that is the algebraic way to write the solution. Up here is the graphical way to write the solution. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.